All right, first of all, I'd just like to say hello to the team out in RDECOM. I am Major General Cedric T. Wins. I'm your new Commanding General. And I wanted to take the opportunity to do what I hope will be at least a monthly or reoccurring event in terms of taking the opportunity to speak to the workforce that is out and about doing all the great things for the Army in the area of research, development, science, and technology. I've been in command going on about 50 days, and I want to impress upon you the level of professionalism, expertise, and true talent that exists across the command. I'd also like to give you a little bit of feedback. We recently went through a change of command, and we've got a new commanding general for Army Material Command. And I'd like to give you a little bit of feedback based on what I foresee the command having to adjust to continue to do the great work that you are currently doing, but to do the work consistent with prioritizing our efforts in focus to what the commanding general is focused on, as well as what the Army is focused on. A little bit of background about me, just so you know where I'm coming from. First thing, I'd probably tell you that I am who I am as a result of three things. The first thing being, I'm a former athlete, having played sports in college, and so what that has taught me is really taught me about the value of teamwork. And I think that that has transcended my career over the past 30 years to understand the importance of teamwork, to understand the importance of individual talent, and how we have to bring that together to get the best out of the organization. The second thing is I have spent a large part of my career, about half of my career, as a field artilleryman. And so as a field artilleryman, I understand the importance of being able to operationalize what we do in the field to get the best effect. And so I have a connection and understanding of what the Army requires for its warfighting forces. And then the third background area that I have is having been, probably for the last 10 years of my career, having been an operations research analyst. And so that has afforded me the opportunity to kind of do some things in the Army headquarters to understand how the Army resources itself, how the Army defines its priorities, how the Army balances its priorities to be able to get after those key areas that the Army is dealing with and has to fund and resource to bring about capability. And so those three areas give me kind of the foundation of what I have coming into this command to understand some of the challenges that we face. I've had an opportunity to get out and see parts of the command. I will take every opportunity to get out and see more of the command in the coming months, coming years. My understanding is there's about 80 to 84 different locations in which RDECOM and the labs and the RDECs are positioned. And it's my intent to get out and see every one of you. From what I've seen so far, I've been extremely impressed by not only the scientists and the engineers that I've come across, but the leadership of the various different decks and labs, and also the support staff that are here to bring about the right type of technological advancements and technological change that the Army must go through in order to ensure that our soldiers have the right capability to go out and do the mission of the joint force and for the nation. And so in the coming months, I'll have an opportunity to get out and see each and every one of you. I think that we are doing some things in the command just to allow us to begin to shift our focus and to better define what it is that this great organization is capable of. I think also that there's an opportunity for us to showcase many of the different areas and efforts that are ongoing in the Army. I've had an opportunity here over the past few months to participate in a number of the various different forums that the Army has had that is showcasing the very thing that we do, which is innovation, technology development, research, and science and technology efforts. And I think those things are very important to the Army going forward, because the Army is going to have the capability to fight and win. The Army's defined the road that it's taking to get after those capabilities, to focus on those areas. where we are losing overmatch, or we have opportunities to gain overmatch in other areas. And by overmatch, I mean where we have a technological advantage or an advantage in terms of our training, our doctrine, our organizations. We have a clear advantage over any adversary that we face. But over the years, given our focus on the two areas of operations that we've had to fight and win in, it's now time for us to refocus our efforts on both innovation and the long-term efforts that we'll have to do that oftentimes come about as a result of innovation, but also invention. And so we're counting on the folks in RDECOM, all the centers and labs, to bring about this type of change. The Army recently had its third Innovation Summit, which was hosted by AMC and took place down at William & Mary, College of William & Mary, and it was jointly hosted by TRADOC and AMC. And it was a great session to allow academia to come in and listen to not only our operational force, but also our science and technology base, and some industry partners to begin to think about some of the things that we have to partner in. And so along those lines, I will tell you that the things that I'm going to be focused on here over probably the next 6 months of command are two areas. The first is bringing about the right types of partnerships, not only with academia, but with industry as well, so that we can work together to identify the key technologies that we're focused on. We can work to blend the talents of industry and academia with the talents that exist within our RDECs and labs to bring about rapid technology that the Army needs. The second area that I'm going to be focused on is how we better establish transitions. Transitions are very important because we do a lot of great things in RDECOM, but our ability to take the things that we're doing and transition those into technology that can go into the capabilities that we need is so very important, and it's an area that I think we can get better in. So I just wanted to tell everyone, number one, thanks for all the great work that you're doing as an organization. Thanks for the commitment that you show towards the Army each and every day. I'm looking forward to getting to know each and every member of the workforce and seeing what it is that you actually do in your location, because I think that's very important that I come to your location to see all the great work that you're doing. And I think over the coming months, you all will hear more from me, you'll hear more from the command team on where I think the Army is going and how we intend to get after those things through a concerted effort to leverage the talent that we have and to define the direction for the Army in terms of how RDECOM leads the way in technology development. So thanks. Look forward to seeing you out there real soon.